my yours, people.
Buddy's in his little house because it's raining hard. We're getting dumped on. Mr. T was in there for a while, and then he went, you know what? It's just too damn, it's raining too hard. I'll just come out here and get something to eat. So watching Mr. T eat, I was trying to get his drip line. If you notice, the sides of his body is kind of still dry. As the rain is running down that drip line. That's why when horses stand out there, I don't know if I can zoom in enough on his foot to see how that hair lets water drip away from him. Yeah, it's not really, between the rain coming down so hard, you really can't tell. Let me try a back foot here. No, the grass is covering it up. Those little feathers that people like to cut off on the back of his feet there. Oh, got to skim out. You're making me sick! Be quiet. Don't cry. Look away till I'm in focus. I'll try to give you a warning. Darn. Mr. T, if you quit moving, I could get in on you, boy. He's like, dude, I gotta be eating. All right, let's get his mouth eaten, pull it up the grass. Chewing. I mean, it takes a lot of grass to keep a horse 1,200 pounds. So, I mean, when a horse is only fed twice a day in a flake, people are like, man, that's a lot of hay. That's a lot. These horses consume a lot of hay because not only is it raining now, it's cooler. He's burning more energy out there. He's got to eat a lot of grass. So, I mean, he's older, so he definitely needs the extra food. Of course, Buddy, he's a youngster, so he can hide in there and stay dry like a little pink powder puff he is. Dad, I can't get wet. I'll melt because I'm sugar. You big baby. All right, so again, I was trying to get that drip line. His belly is not going to be wet. It's hard to tell because it's raining so hard. But, and you can tell his colors are changing. He goes from a brown to like that, where he's really black. That's why they call him a seal brown. Because when seals get wet in the water, they look black. But when they dry out in the sun, they're brown. So you can tell his butt and everything that's getting wet is a lot darker. And he's got to get out there eating. Again, it's been raining for a good, I don't know, maybe a half hour, maybe a couple hours, I don't know. But it kind of comes in big downpours and it slows down a little bit. So they were both under the shed for an hour or so, and then Mr. T just said, hey, we can't hide in here forever. I got to go out and get some energy and keep food going through my body. So I just wish I could get those feathers, because I guarantee you there's like a little drip line running down those feathers. Oh, Mr. T, right as I got on it, you moved. I just can't get it. People will be like, why are you trying to make me sick? Okay, hang on, Mr. T, don't move. Oh, my God. All right, I can't get it. So anyway, again, it's pretty windy out there. It's raining. I mean, I don't want to be out in it. You can see the trees moving, and it's kind of coming down pretty hard, and there's a good wind. But, look, horses can handle this. This isn't the end of the world. I mean, again, when I was at Travis, and the horses were there, when it started sprinkling, and I mean, this is a good rain. It didn't rain that much this hard in California. It usually sprinkled a little bit. It was kind of pansy rain, like the whole damn state. But anyway, man, you would see people leaving work, women coming out in droves, racing. There was a line to get into the stables because people had to run out and get their horse out of the rain because they didn't want their horse to have to stand out in the rain. And I'm just like, are you kidding me? And of course, I was the bad guy for leaving my guys out. He doesn't love his horse. He just leaves him out there to get rain. Mr. T has a choice to come in or not, and he's out in the rain, you big dummy. People in the horse world just, they have to believe only what they're told and what they want to believe. You know, a kid has to wear a coat when the mom's cold. And that's the big thing in a horse world. A horse has to wear a blanket when the mom's hot. Horse has to come in out of the rain when the mom doesn't want to get wet. You know, it's just, I just wish people would let horses be horses. Now, The flip side of that is if they didn't have cover and they always had to stand in the rain and it was cold and it was raining for a week straight and they didn't have any trees and they were locked in a little stall to where they couldn't get exercise and they couldn't walk and they couldn't eat, well, then that's the other side of abuse. But letting my horse run around out here in the rain when, of course, one of them has a choice to stay in and he chooses to stay in, the other one has a choice to be in, he chooses to be out. Horses are going to do different things, and it's not up to us to run and save them on what we think is best and what we think we should do, because that's what we would do if we were a horse, but we've never been a horse. We don't know how to think like a horse. We want to think like a human and think horses are human and babies and children, and then we end up treating them to where it's not good for them. So Mr. T's out there again, grazing and eating. He's got to keep that food going in. It's lightning and thunder out there a little bit. I mean, I've seen a whole bunch of streak lightning, but hey, horses just can't be worrying about that crap. It's like, hey, I got to, sorry, I'm moving my little thing here, trying to get his little mouth in here, because he's eating pretty, the other horsey head's in the way. All right, he's going to move in, and there you go. We'll watch his little mouth eating there. So he's just nibbling a little grass here. Again, 1,200 pounds is a lot of weight to be keeping on for eating a stinking salad. So, I mean, he is eating just straight up grass, trying to keep, and that's good for him. He's keeping his system moving. He's keeping his things going in and things going out. When horses stop eating and stop pooping, that's when you got problems. So as long as he's eating, that means something's coming out. And, you know, and believe me, Mr. T is not out there saying, oh, I got a bad owner. He's making me stand in the rain. I got such a hard life. I've talked about that one little saying. Well, what's that? A bird will die frozen on the line and never feel sorry for himself. A couple people have put the guy that said, I can't ever remember his name. But anyway, that's just the way animals are. I mean, Mr. T standing out there is not feeling sorry for himself. He's just like, hey, it's raining, I'm getting wet, and I'm going to eat because I got to eat to survive, and I'm going to look for predators. And I'm going to keep my butt to the wind. You notice his tail blowing between his legs? A lot of horses' tails are always blowing between their legs. That's because they're always standing with their butt to the wind. So a lot of pictures of a lot of horses, you'll always see their tail blowing between their legs because their butt's to the wind. They know. He's trying to protect his eyes so he can see. He's trying to keep the back of his ears to the wind and the weather coming. So therefore, he's facing away from the wind, which will protect him, you know, from water going down his ears and water going in his eyes. He's got some drip lines around his face to where the water goes around. So Mr. T is not, I'm going to get somebody here. That guy hates his horses. He should put a blanket or dry him, or he should be out there with an umbrella. Freaking idiots. Go get a damn pink umbrella for Buddy. I'm getting you a pink umbrella. That's it. You're getting a pink umbrella, boy. It's like, Dad, don't be mean to me. I'm a poor, abused horse. All right. Well, little more, again, normal horse behavior. I try to get people to realize and see horses not from what they're told, not from what stupid Hollywood portrays them in their movies, not from the lifelong barn witches or lifelong horse owners. I've owned horses my whole life, and this is what I've done, and I know because I've owned them. Any idiot can own a horse. There's no test. See, he's backing into that wind. Instead of walking forward, he's just backing up. So, you know, there's no test to own a horse. So any idiot could own it, and you can own it for 50 years. You know, there's a lot of parents out there, well, that's my kid, and I'm a parent. Any idiot can have sex and have a kid. It's not some freaking great special thing. There's no test, there's no requirement, and it's damn hard to stop them from being a parent. And you know what? It's damn hard to stop idiots from owning horses. So, Mr. T's out there doing fine. He ain't worried about it, and he's made a choice, and Buddy has his choice, and he's made his choice. His little back legs cocked there, and he's just kind of like, I'll just chill out in the shade. I don't need to eat. Again, he can process food. He's younger. He's not maybe not as cold as Mr. T. Maybe he's doesn't feel like the energy. You see, because he's not standing with his butt to wind. Notice his tail is blowing to the left of him, or to the left of the camera here, to the right of Buddy, and because he's standing sideways to the rain, because he's trying to stay more in the shade. because the rain's kind of blowing in there. The wind's coming in. I'm surprised he's not closer to the wall. Now, he's going to get nervous because, especially the more Mr. T moves to where he can't see him, he can probably see me through the window right now, so he's got a little comfort. But the more Mr. T moves out of his way, the more Buddy's going to get a little bit nervous. So good old Mr. T's out there just eating. As soon as it slows down enough, I'll probably go give him some... Man, we got a lot of rain. I mean, I know we get a lot of rain when the water starts puddling up, because normally it just soaks in pretty good. And when I get this good water flow here, they're flash flood warning and stuff. I know I'm getting some good dumping. So all the trees and everything are getting good, and the poop piles are getting knocked down, and the trails are turning into little horse paths are turning into little lakes and rivers and streams. That's okay. Oh, Mr. T, how do you get your horse not to be scared of thunder, Rick? You don't get a horse not to be scared of thunder. They learn on their own because they got a stinking brain. They understand that, hey, it happens. It thunders. There's flashes. Well, my horse is scared of fireworks. Yeah, my horses are scared of fireworks too, because that's not natural. It's not raining. It doesn't cool off. They don't associate it with the weather. They can't predict it. They can't understand that it happens with bad weather and thunderstorms. Horses learn that those go together. But July 4th and January 1st for the new year, when people are out there writing off firing guns and doing stuff in the middle of the night, and there's large flashes of light of things falling associated with a big bang, that's not normal. And that's why horses freak out, and that's why they get scared, because they can't predict. It's not done enough to where it becomes a routine or normal. Somebody made a comment on one of my videos, which I thought was great, is they said, I knew a girl who protected her horse so much that the horse was psychotic when anything happened out of the ordinary. And I was like, that's exactly what you do. When you don't sack your horse out, when you don't expose them to things that scare them, when you don't do, move the camera here, warning, watch your eyes. When you don't do things to get your horse exposed to different things, they become so much routine, so used and desensitized to anything abnormal happening that when something abnormal happens, they freak out. And that's how you get spooky, scared horses that you can't control. And you fear is good for horses. It's good for them to experience things. That's why I say sacking out is a good thing. You know, I'll get mainly the English and the jumpers and the hunters and the dressages that, oh, you shouldn't do that. If you just ride your horse in an arena and wear a helmet and run in circles, you'll be fine. You'll only get in trouble if you get out of the arena and ride your horse somewhere to where you can't control the environment. Then that's when you'll get in trouble. And, you know, I see it the other way. You ride your horse everywhere. You expose him to everything. You change his environment all the time. He gets used to it. You learn how to deal with it. You become a team and a partner. And no matter what happens, you're not going to need your helmet to protect you, because you and your horse understand each other and you have a relationship and you can handle whatever happens without jumping off doing an emergency dismount or screaming saying my horse ran me into a tree. Stupid shit like that runs around a horse world. Anyway, I thought it was kind of interesting. We were getting some really good rain and the wind, and Mr. T was like, you know what? I've had enough of this shelter. Buddy, stay in there. I'm going out. And so he's out there eating his little grass and keeping things moving. He's a good boy. All right, so that's a little Mr. T in the rain and Buddy being a pansy. I swear, that horse damn thinks he's a damn human sometimes. All right, well, in that there, Buddy, Mr. T, you're good boys.